Folks, here we go. We're about to get into the James Bond. We're Die Another Friday feature we have going on here over at giantbomb.com. Everybody is seated. Looks like they are deep in conversation, just ready to go. We're going to kick it over in just a couple of minutes here. Actually, less than that. We're going to have a pre-show. Oh, just getting keyboards all set, moving stuff around. It's Friday. It's Friday, folks. I don't know if you're aware of that. I'm pretty happy for the Friday. A long weekend coming up. You guys ready over there?
Yeah,
that's two double thumbs up. All right, here we go. I'm going to take it down the black. Hold on to your butts, folks. Yeah. Die Another Friday coming up in just a moment.
You know, on the third Thursday stuff,
mm-hmm.
they do a thing here at the office that they give us free, or they are supposed to give us free food.
Food and, an assortment of drinks.
Right. And by the time we leave, because we record the Beastcast mm-hmm. On Thursday afternoon / early evening, you go out there and it's picked pretty clean.
Usually, yes.
Mm-hmm. I was hungry. I was ready. Texted my wife saying, like, hey, I'm going to eat here. It's third Thursday. Walk out there and it's just like... cold macaroni and cheese, no more wings, no more, like, you know, we don't get to partake. It's worse. We have to hear the mocking fun times
yes.
of our fellow coworkers through this wall as they dine and feast upon the food that we may never have.
Yeah, I take the whole thing as a grave personal insult.
I do too. And that's why I tend to, the one thing I can salvage is sometimes they do have a giant cooler and they got some free beers in there.
Yeah.
And so...
it's Coors Light.
You know what? They had a bunch of fancy craft beers in there.
Yeah.
Like those big cans of like, they had a whole assortment of these weird craft beers, but I just don't like those. And I think Coors Light is a solid product.
I don't think there's anything wrong with not liking fancy beer. That's by all means. There's lots of fancy beer that I find completely undrinkable. I also find Coors Light most American light beers completely undrinkable.
I find them to be the default beer.
Fair enough.
Bud Light, Coors Light, Miller Light.
Really, there's a wide swath of America that would agree with you about
yes.
that.
And it's all interchangeable to me.
Yes.
Like, I like all that type of beer. Pepsi challenged me and put a blindfold. Is that the Pepsi challenge? Blindfold on me and had me drink out of a bunch of
more or
cups.
Less. Yeah, yeah.
No chance in hell I could tell you the difference. If it was like a Guinness, I would know the
oh,
difference.
Oh, yeah. I mean, if you're talking about like different individual beer types, I could certainly, the more severe ones, I could
right.
certainly pick out in a lineup.
I don't know what hoppy means.
Hoppy is you. Do you ever drink IPAs?
Yeah,
that's kind of like the flavor that is sort of associated with IPA is just like a heavy hop flavor.
Okay.
I think
I drink like IPA. Like if it's a thing where it's like, oh, here's our special right now. IPAs are $5, and like this would be $6. It's like, okay, I'll branch out and I'll do an IPA. I mean, it's never my like drink of choice.
Yeah. I grew up drinking a lot of Lagunitas, so that is
an IPA.
Yeah,
are they the watermelon beer people in San Francisco? The Heller High watermelon.
I've never had that.
That's a fancy beer I like because it tastes like watermelon.
I mean, yeah, I've got no beef with fruity beers. Mm-hmm. That's totally fine by me. Lagunitas was a brewery that is in Petaluma.
Gotcha.
And
okay.
they are a nationwide sort of brand. So it was just a hometown thing. Drank a lot of it.
I had seen them all over the place, but it was when I lived in San Francisco that I noticed that they were much more prevalent everywhere.
Yes.
Like that was like
they are.
Kinda,
I think
IPA,
they're owned by Heineken now, so like they're you know like I said they're everywhere.
Aren't there like two beer companies and they make all
like three?
Yeah, doesn't like Budweiser make fancy beers too? Like don't they own Blue Moon or something?
Oh yeah, like all those major like chain like the beers that would essentially be the McDonald's of beers. Like they also have their Chipotle and you know sort of fancier brands that they carry around as well.
You know, it's weird. Dr. Pepper. Dr. Pepper is not it's not a Coke or a Pepsi thing.
Who owns that?
And it's like the Dr. Pepper company. I think it's like Dr. Pepper and 7-Up. Like, because everything kind of falls under the Pepsi or Coke umbrella for the most part.
Yeah.
One's got their Mountain Dew. One's got their Mellow Yellow or whatever.
Naturally.
But Dr. Pepper is in the weird no man's land. Mr. Pibb is Coke's version of Dr. Pepper. But I think Dr. Pepper is like the Dr. Pepper / 7-Up company.
It is owned by Dr. Pepper.
Yes, yes. He's a very wealthy doctor. He's been doing it for a long time. It's surprising that no one swept them up, you know?
Yeah, maybe they just, they had the funds to avoid getting bought. You know, they are a beloved soda brand among all soda brands, and, you know, there's no need for them. I was going to say sell out, but I mean, who would they sell out to? They're a major brand already.
Yeah. Dr. Pepper Stacy. I'm like, hey, look at that.
Ah.
Is that? Yeah, there
that's
it is.
That.
Look at that. Now, here's the thing. I'm going to warn everyone.
Uh-huh.
I can already tell I'm going to have to pee during the stream, and not because of the beers. I've had two sips out of this goddamn beer here, and I can already feel the pee creeping up, and it's not because of this. So if this is the first Die Another Friday where I actually do have to run out and pee in my stupid tux, know I had to pee from the beginning.
Okay.
Or kind of. Like, I don't need to. It's not an emergency. I'm going to try to make it through. I'm going to try to beat whatever level we're on.
We'll be here to support you.
Thank you. Thank you. We'll have Vinny Carabella out here in a bit.
Yes.
But yeah.
Should we start this show?
How are we looking?
That's a thumbs up.
There we go. All right. Yeah. Wait. We're not in the frame.
Well, I am.
There we go. Oh, there we go. Yeah. You got it. Oh, yeah. That's the best 64 controller. Look at that.
Oh, yeah.
Does it have the chalk? A lot of them get the little, like, weird chalk thing here.
Yeah.
No?
Nah, it doesn't hide.
I've seen a whole lot of these working out of Funko Land back in 2000. A lot of people trading in 64s. And look at this crap. Bunch of people. Vinny, if you took this shit into my Funko Land back in 2000, I would have been pissed. Look at this shit.
You can't
wait for it. It's going to pay off.
We're zooming.
It's going to pay
zooming.
Off.
We're zooming.
Come on.
Other direction.
That yeah, shit. Fucking where's the lid? If you're going to trade this shit in, you better have a lid.
But I'm not trading that shit in. That's mine.
Is that your 64?
That's my 64.
Do you know where the lid is?
I don't know.
Just no respect for the consoles.
Look, man, I've had this console for like 20 goddamn years. Know, shit gets lost.
It's an aesthetic part of, like, it affects the entire look of the console. Like, I'm glad you have the expansion pack. That shows that you're a serious hardcore gamer.
I am.
You got that 4 megs of extra memory for Perfect Dark multiplayer. I know. I get it. But keep the fucking lid. You're not who you're
impressing. Well, I had the lid for many years. It just eventually fell off and I lost it.
All right. Well, I wouldn't accept that trade-in.
So. Well, I'm not trading it in. It's my N64. I'm not going to get rid of that.
Well, I don't work for GameStop anymore. So there.
Well, all right.